Welcome back to Rich Words Music, where today we're looking at this. It's the 2024 Ibanez Premium S1070 PBZ in charcoal black burst. This is an Ibanez Premium guitar made in Indonesia to the highest of build quality, and the S series, or the Saber series, is one of Ibanez's own original designs, and it kind of looks like this. It's a super thin-bodied rock and roll machine with the finest appointments, and in this case a locking trem as well. It's got an HSH pickup configuration, and it should be a fantastically versatile and an amazing sounding instrument for pretty much every genre that I put it through its paces with today, even though it looks pretty metal. Now, I personally have never owned a guitar with a Floyd Rose or a locking bridge like this Ibanez Edge 02 contraption that we've got here, so I'm kind of a little bit nervous about how it's going to be in terms of maintenance, in terms of tuning and stuff like that. But I know people who love Floyd Roses, and for them it's the only thing that they will ever play. But anyway, in this video what I'm going to do is take you through the specs and the features of this guitar, then we'll play it in as many different musical styles as I can possibly manage, and at the end I'll give you a few more in-depth opinions and give you my thoughts about having had this guitar for a few weeks and played it quite a lot in that time. So let's go first into those specs and features then. Now, this guitar is a 2024 model, but the S1070 PBZ did already exist. It's the charcoal black burst that is new for this year, and it's a fantastic looking instrument. Look at it there, we've got a poplar burl on the top, which is a real eye catcher, and if I twist this round to the back, you can see there that the neck is already looking very, very exotic, but I will get into those neck woods in a bit, and we'll start with the body. Now, the other thing that you'll notice straight away is that this guitar has, like all of the S series by Ibanez, a very, very thin body. It's much thinner than a standard Les Paul, Telecaster or Strat or something like that, and it really sticks itself close to your body. You've got contours as well that really make it appear to be an extension of yourself, as opposed to a guitar that is strapped to you. This guitar becomes a piece of you straight away, so that's a pretty cool thing and a very different feeling for someone like me who normally plays more traditional guitars. Now, I said we've got this beautiful charcoal black burst and poplar burl on the top of the guitar as well, but there are a bunch of woods involved in the body of this one. So on the top, which is 16.5 millimeters thick, we've got that poplar burl, we've got walnut, we've got curly maple, and we've got panga panga. And the body of the guitar and the back here is made of African mahogany. Now, because it's quite a thin body, you'd expect this to be a lightweight guitar, but with the bridge and with the mahogany, it's actually quite weighty. This specific one is 3.58 kilograms, which is just under 8 pounds, 7 pounds 14 or something like that. So it's a decent weight and it balances really well too, but it's not quite as light overall as you would imagine. So body aside, we come to the pickups and the hardware, and we've got three Damasio pickups in this guitar, a humbucker in the neck and the bridge, and a single coil in the middle. Now, the neck humbucker is the Damasio Air Norton. In the bridge, we've got the Tone Zone, and in the middle we've got the classically voiced True Velvet single coils. So an HSH pickup configuration that should give us access to many, many different tones. And we've got a five-way selector switch on this guitar and a couple of cool switching options too. Beginning up at the top here, and you have access to the full neck humbucker, the Damasio Air Norton. Move the selector switch down one and you access the middle single coil and the inner coil of the neck humbucker. So that's true single coil, perhaps quacky Stratocaster-esque tones, but we'll hear that in the playing parts. The middle selection is just that True Velvet Damasio single coil. The second position down here is the True Velvet middle single coil and the inner coil of the bridge humbucker. Again, single coil, coil split-esque, Fender Strat-esque tones. And down at the bottom, we're in full Damasio Tone Zone, full fat humbucking glory. So that's the pickups. We've got the five-way switch, a master volume, and a master tone control. And finally down here, we've got the Ibanez Edge 02 locking bridge trem whammy system. And this is something which is a bit of a mystery to me, I have to say. I've not got any experience with a bridge like this, but Ibanez themselves say that this design features a lower profile tremolo for playing comfort and a stud lock function for stable tuning. In addition, the zero point system provides much greater tuning stability. Well, we'll be the judge of that once I play this and give the bar a bit of a wobble once I'm doing the playing part. Again, let's just look at the back of the body there, and you can see that African mahogany. And you can also see that on the back here we have a panel where we can change the string tension on the Edge 02 bridge there. So let's move up to the neck of the S1070 PBZ, and you can see again that we've got quite an exotic design here. We'll start by flicking it over to the back, and you can see that this is actually actually an 11-piece neck. This one's made up of panga panga, maple, walnut, and bubinga, and it's a very, very exotic looking thing. Put it this way, if you bring this guitar to band practice, you're going to start a few conversations, that's for sure. Now, you've got 24 jumbo stainless steel frets on this rosewood fingerboard, and you've got glow-in-the-dark luminescent side dot inlays as well, so you're never going to lose your place all the way up to the 24th fret when you're playing on dark stages. We have a 25.5-inch scale length. We have a 400mm fingerboard radius. That's 15¾ inches, so very, very flat. And we've got a 43mm locking nut in this case. Moving up to the headstock, you can see that the charcoal black burst finish continues there too. And we've got Goto locking machine heads there on the back. So this is the 2024 Ibanez Premium S1070 PBZ in charcoal black burst. The one thing I haven't shown you visually is the fact that this guitar also comes with a fairly decent Ibanez gig bag. It's got a decent amount of padding, so it's not going to be too bad. Not the best gig bag I've ever seen, but decent enough nonetheless. Anyway, next we're going to play this guitar in as many different musical styles as I can possibly manage. My rig for today is going to be my Hughes & Kettner Black Spirit 200 amp head, and we'll start on the amp's clean channel with just a little bit of reverb. We'll go through all of the different pickup combinations and we'll play some poppy stuff, some folky stuff, some blues, stuff like that. Then we'll kick in my favorite overdrive pedal, that's the Greer Lightspeed, and we'll play some of my favorite genre, that's a bit of indie rock music. After that, we'll go to the amp's crunch channel and try some classic rock and some AC/DC sort of tones. Then we'll head to the lead channel and try some harder rock and some punk rock and some progressive rock. And at the end, we'll go back to the clean channel. I'll engage my high gain Rev G3 distortion pedal and we'll see if the S1070 can't do a bit of metal, and I'm sure that it will be able to do that, absolutely no problems at all. Enough talk then, it's the 2024 Ibanez Premium S1070 PBZ in charcoal black burst. Let's play it now and we'll speak in more detail about it afterwards. We'll be right back. Okay then, so that was the 2024 Ibanez Premium S1070 PBZ in charcoal black burst, and I hope you enjoyed the playing and the tones. Now, when Ibanez Germany told me that they were going to be sending me this guitar to test it out, I thought, come on guys, what are you doing? I'm not a metal player by heart, even though I had a bit of a metal phase when I was younger, and I'm not someone who's ever owned a guitar with a locking trem and a locking nut like this before, although of course I've tried them out in my time. And they said, well, we want to challenge you. We want to hear the sounds that you can get out of this guitar. So that's what this video is. Now, the guys at Ibanez Germany also sent me the RG421S, and that was a guitar that really surprised me at how good it was for the price. You can see a video of that one there. And this one, well, I had even higher hopes because it's much more expensive. It's one of the Ibanez premium guitars. This one actually has a recommended retail price in Europe of 1,749 euros. In America, you'll pay about $1,400 for it, and in the UK, about £1,450 as of time of filming. So this is not an affordable guitar by any means. It's $1,000 or euros more expensive than the RG421 that I tried out, and so I had high hopes. I'd like to hear what you guys think about locking bridges, about Floyd Roses and locking nuts and stuff like that. Are they worth the extra effort? Are the tones and the sounds that you get out of them worth it for the extra maintenance that you have to do to guitars? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. But what I'm going to do now is give you a few more detailed thoughts and opinions about my experiences with the S1070. And my first impressions were pretty good because the gig bag that this guitar comes with as standard is fairly decent. It's fairly well padded, so no problems there. Now, there are better gig bags out there, but those are going to be more expensive offerings. So when I got the guitar out of the gig bag, I was shocked and surprised at how thin it is. I've never really had an S guitar like this in my hands before, and it's really, really sleek. And the sleekness continues throughout the rest of the guitar. The neck is just really, really slim and fast and satin feeling. It does feel like a fast car or something like that. I was also taken aback at the beautiful finish on this guitar. It does look pretty metal, but it is a wonderful looking thing, an absolute artwork in guitar form. Now, I was also taken aback by the weight of this guitar. This specific one is 3.58 kilograms, which is about £7.14 or just under £8. That's a good weight, but when you see this guitar and when you consider the thin body, you could have imagined that it would have been just a little bit lighter. But anyway, not a problem for me personally. So those were my first impressions out of the way. And the next thing that I looked at was the build quality. And well, the S1070 PBZ conforms to the Ibanez standard that I've come to expect over recent years. And that's that this guitar has been built to a basically flawless standard. You can't find any imperfections anywhere in the finish or anything like that. The guitar, the neck, it all seems to have been done fantastically well. And in terms of the setup that came out of the factory, well, this guitar has been set up very well indeed. The jumbo frets feel fantastic, the rolled fretboard edges really, really nice, and all of the hardware does its job just as it should, of course. The one thing that was a bit of a consternation to me as soon as I got the guitar out of the box and strummed an open E chord was the fact that it wasn't quite 100% in tune, and that was my first issue with the locking bridge. I came to realize that we've got some fine tuning knobs here that you can twist a little bit to get the guitar into tune, and that worked for me, but I was worried for a second. I was thinking that I was going to have to get out the multi-tool that ships with this guitar and start taking off the nut and doing all sorts of stuff that I am by no means an expert at doing. So thank goodness I didn't have to do that. So that was the build quality. Top marks all round for that. And then we come to the playability, and this guitar's clearly been designed to be as sleek and as comfortable and as ergonomic as possible when it comes to playing and performing at your best. Now, we've got this beautiful wizard profile neck here, which is very, very thin and flat feeling, but supremely comfortable as well. It's much thinner than most of the guitars that I personally own in my collection, but it's a lot of fun to play as well. Like I've already said, the frets have been done perfectly and you've got these beautiful rolled edges. It makes it a joy to play all the way up to the 24th fret, and the flat fingerboard really makes it easy to do solos and lead playing all the way up to the top end if that's what you like to do. In terms of the body of this guitar, the thin width of it here makes it really easy for it to suck into your body and really attach itself to you. You've got nice contours, great cutaways to aid the upper fret access as well. The playability of this guitar, well, it's basically second to none in my opinion. Really, really easy to play and really, really easy to get the best out of yourself as a musician when playing this guitar. And the other crucial thing that we need to talk about in this video are the sounds on offer with this guitar. Now, we've got three Damasio pickups in this guitar, the Air Norton in the neck, the True Velvet single coil in the middle, and the Tone Zone humbucker at the bridge. And I was able to play a bunch of different sound examples utilizing all three of the pickups and sometimes sometimes flicking directly between them during riffs, and I have to say that this is a wonderful, a premium sounding guitar in every respect. Those Damasio pickups are fantastic, and they all give you top tones, no matter what genre, no matter what style of music that you're playing at any one time. Starting with the clean sounds, we were able to get everything from really warm, jazzy neck humbucker tones through to quite biting, quite high output, sort of broken up clean tones from the Tone Zone humbucker in the bridge. We were also able to get really nice classic quacky in between 2 and 4 position sounds, very Fender Strat-esque from the 2 and 4 positions, but the star performer for me on the cleans was the True Velvet single coil in the middle. That gives really biting sounds. It's great for folk, it's great for country, it's great for indie strumming too. It's a really, really nice sounding pickup. And when we went up to the crunch sounds with the Greer Lightspeed at first and then the crunch channel on the amplifier, well, all of these pickups excel at that too. The Tone Zone in the bridge here is a fantastic humbucker for AC/DC type, classic 70s rock, that sort of stuff. Really fat and aggressive and mid-rangey sounding. And, well, I'm personally a very big proponent of using the middle single coil in a Fender Strat type guitar, a la Albert Hammond Jr. from The Strokes. I love the indie rock sounds that he gets from his guitar like that, and the True Velvet single coil in the S1070 PBZ really worked well for that. It's kind of surprising that this guitar sounds so good for lower gain indie rock stuff, but hey, it could do a job for me in any situation in that genre. When we went up to the higher gain territories of the lead channel and with the Rev G3 distortion pedal, well, it feels like where this guitar is totally at home, and it sounds fantastic and full and thick and fat for metal, just the same as it does for hard rock and punk rock and progressive rock and everything else, with quite a lot of overdrive. It's a fantastic sounding guitar, and these Damasio pickups really do give you an air of tonal luxury, no matter what style of music that you're playing. Now, regular viewers of my channel will have noticed that today I didn't tune a guitar down to drop D to do the metal stuff, which I normally tend to do for these demos, and that brings me round to the one big reservation that I personally have about this guitar, and that's the Edge 02, this locking bridge and nut. This is just something that for me, I'm a total beginner with, and I wasn't prepared to risk the time and the stress and the tearing out of my hair trying to retune the guitar just to play a handful of riffs for 90 seconds or anything like that. You can call me lazy in the comments, and I would appreciate it if you do, because I love comments of all kinds, but I think even in standard tuning, this guitar sounded really heavy. However, to go back to that negative point, for me personally, I think it's going to take quite a while for me to really get into a locking bridge and a locking nut and that kind of stuff. It just seems like something which, for me personally, as someone who doesn't use a bar that much, is not that necessary. And there's one other little story that I have about that. As I was getting to the end of my playing demo part, well, I really started abusing the bar and trying to get as big bends and dive bombs out of it as I could. And at some point, I'd gone too far with it and I couldn't get the guitar back into tune. The top E string was a semitone down and I couldn't get it back up to standard tuning with the fine tuning wheel here. And I didn't want to get out the multi-tool and a screwdriver and start tuning it that way just to carry on playing. But that new tuning actually gave me some really nice bar chords to play some clean stuff. And I'll just give you a little sample of that now. So actually not being able to tune this guitar properly opened me up to a new tuning that I'd never thought about before and made something pretty nice. I've had a few creative ideas with it since then, and I shall continue developing that into a song. It's not something that you're supposed to expect with a bridge like this, but hey, it worked for me. So thanks, Ibanez, for opening me up to this new weird tuning. But again, for me personally, this fixed bridge is going to take some getting used to. I know there's going to be a bunch of you out there who love that kind of thing, and for you it's going to be perfect, and it should not put you off the guitar in any way. It works fantastically for what it is. It's just something that for me is not in my resume, at least not yet. So if you've been watching this video and you really like what you've seen from this guitar, but you're wondering what else is out there, well, there's a bunch of stuff. If you're looking for HSH guitars or Super Strats, there are so many out there. And for this sort of price point, you can basically pick and choose whatever you want. Even from Ibanez, there are so many others in this ballpark sort of price range with different pickups, different necks, different body shapes, and so on. You can really spend a bunch of time time at your local dealer finding which one works best for you. Like I said, there are a bunch of other Ibanezes that look and sound and feel and play just like this one, but a specific RG that I saw, the RG T1270, is very, very similar to this guitar, but just happens to be in the RG format. So that's definitely going to be worth considering and looking at if you're looking at a guitar like this one. But if you're looking at Superstrats generally and HSH pickup configurations, well, there are so many other options. You could go to Charvel, you could go to ESP, you could go to Jackson, you could even go for some of the HSH Fender Player Series Strats for a slightly more traditional take on this. There are going to be so many, and I really recommend that you try them out yourself and find the one that works best for you. And if you're someone on a budget, like me generally, and you want to spend about 300 to 400 euros instead of 1500 or 1600 like this guitar costs, well, you could try something like the Harley Benton Fusion range. Those are S-type guitars, double cutaways with HSH pickup configurations or other configurations available too. Different color options as well, fantastic playing instruments for the money, and always worth a look if you're on a budget but want something like this. At the end of the day then, I'm hugely impressed and surprised by the Ibanez S1070 PBZ. It's a really, really well put together guitar, and it's totally different from anything that I would normally play, but it's loads of fun and it sounds fantastic too. Now, this guitar will set you back about 1700 euros or $1400 or $1500, so it's by no means cheap, especially for a made in Indonesia guitar. However, it comes with a gig bag and it's got a bunch of great stuff built into it too. Primarily, you've got these amazing Dimarzio pickups and they're all fantastic at what they do. And then we've got a bunch of other appointments that make this guitar as easy to play as possible. You've got this beautiful neck with the rosewood board, the 24 jumbo stainless steel frets, this really, really nice and thin and slinky wizard neck profile. Really, really cool. And I have to say, totally different to my normal thing, but plays like a dream. At the body, this is going to be the thing that either puts you off or turns you on. But if you're a fan of locking bridges and locking nuts and whammy bars and doing dive bombs, well, it's going to be no problem for you whatsoever. If you're someone just getting into that kind of thing, like me, well, it's simply going to take a bit of time for you to work your way into how these sorts of things function. And you will spend hours probably watching YouTube videos on how to tune your guitar for a bit. But I assume that once you get used to it, it becomes second nature. Apart from that though, no complaints whatsoever about this guitar. It looks fantastic, it feels fantastic, it plays fantastic, and I'd quite like to have it in my collection for a bit longer to really get to know it a bit more and also to learn how to tune it properly. I hope that this video has answered all of the questions that you might have had about this guitar, but if there's anything else you want to know, drop me a line down there in the comments and I shall do my best to answer you to the fullest of my abilities. And if you're still around, it would really make my day if you wanted to give the video a like, or maybe even drop my channel a sub, because that really does help. But that's been it for today's video. I've been Rich for Rich Words Music, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.